Hi everyone, Sherry here. Just wanted to hang out with everybody for a little bit today and answer any questions you've been having from our webinars. And I hope you've been enjoying them. We've been having so much fun. Everyone has been so sweet and so interactive on the webinars. They've been asking lots of questions. And if we didn't answer your question on the webinar, please, you know, send us an email, post in the Facebook group. We're happy to answer your questions. Sometimes it's so crazy during the webinar that we actually don't get to answer your questions. So we love you. We are not ignoring you. So please make sure you ask your question here. So I was going to hang out in the group for a little while, and I'm happy to answer anything that you might be wondering about the Retreats Made Easy program, something that you heard during the webinar and you weren't sure about. But until anyone actually asks a question, I'm going to answer some that we actually got emailed about. So I figure if one person has a question about that topic, someone else has the same question, right? So, a number of people have been asking if the program is right for them based on their situation. So let's go over that. So Megan and I created Retreats Made Easy for people who wanted a simpler, more basic system than the Retreat Blueprint, which is our program we've been running for a couple of years now. And there were many people who said, can you please just simplify it for people who want to do something locally, more simple? They're not traveling all over the world. They don't need all that hoo-ha. They just want something more simple and direct. So what we did is we honed things down. We looked at what is really critical. What do people have to know to basically get started. So the program is geared more towards people who are brand new in their business and people who want to do something local. However, that does not mean because you already ran a retreat, you can't take the program. For example, if you ran a retreat before and you didn't make the money you thought that you would, to me, you're still a retreat virgin, because until you actually make money on your retreat, it's really not a successful retreat. Maybe it's successful. Of course, the people enjoyed it and you enjoyed it and it was a blessing. And for sure, all those things are important, but it is important to actually make a profit in your business. So, I would recommend the course if you're more in that new stage, or you know, you've never run a retreat before, you want to do something locally, your business is just starting, you don't have all the pieces in place, maybe you don't have a list at all, or you don't have a great list, or you have a small list. All of those are good reasons to be taking Retreats Made Easy. Now, let's say you're going to do international retreats. If you're going to do international retreats, you should take the Retreat Blueprint program. And this is one of the main reasons why. The legal form that's in the Retreats Made Easy program is specific for local retreats. The forms that you get in the Retreat Blueprint are much more complex. To give you a comparison, the legal form in Retreats Made Easy is 2 pages long. The legal form in Retreat Blueprint is 6 pages long, and there's good reason for that. So we want to protect our community. I know a lot of you are asking, well, if I'm in Asia or I'm in England or I'm in Europe, can I still use the forms? Yes. The forms are written in a way to protect you while you're on a retreat, okay? So the best thing to do is have your lawyer, a lawyer, look over it. And if there's any slight wording that needs to be changed for your locality, that's fine. Like a lot of people say, well, Sherry, you're in the United States. It's not good for me here or there. Even in the United States, the laws in our country really change from state to state. So it doesn't matter. Everyone should still have it looked at. Just because a legal form is generic, it does not mean it's necessarily perfect for your area. So think of it this way, like for our retreat blueprint program, those 6 pages originally cost me around $3,000 for my lawyer to make from scratch. So if you look at that, having your lawyer look at it for 20 minutes and read through it is nothing. It's not expensive at all. Compared to paying $3,000 to have it made for scratch, it's the same thing for Retreats Made Easy. It would probably cost about $1,000 to have that made from scratch. And all you have to do is bring the finished product in and have someone read 2 pages. I mean, that's not going to take long. So you're saving an enormous amount of money. Even the legal forms in the 2 programs more than cover the price of the program itself. Plus, the other price, which is in your protection, which is really important because most people actually run retreats not totally legally, like they're not insured and they don't have legal forms and they're not aware of seller of travel laws in their area. So for example, one thing most Canadians are familiar with is they have very serious seller of travel law, especially in Ontario. TECO is really on retreat leaders, and you have to follow that. And otherwise, you can get in trouble. So Petra says, does the program gear to Canadian laws as well? Yes, because seller of travel law is seller of travel law, and it is pretty consistent around the world. Like where there are seller of travel laws, they're pretty similar. Yes, TECO is on us. I get it, Pet. Yeah, I know. So the thing is, for you in Canada, you want to run your retreat through a travel agency. You can't accept money for selling travel. That's the whole key. And we have that in the United States too. So you still should have legal forms to protect yourself. Doesn't matter if you're running the retreat through a travel agency, you need to be protected. So that's why I say those legal forms are good no matter what. Now you still have to obey seller of travel law, which you're aware of, obviously. So good on you because you're on top of things. And that makes me feel happy because I want everyone to be protected properly. So very good. Very good for knowing that law. So Petra's saying, yes, I've been teaming up with wellness travel agents. Excellent. Perfect. You're doing the right thing. Just make sure you're not having them just sign a waiver because that won't cover your butt. And the thing is this, today we have people from all over the world joining us on our retreats. So the best thing is to cover yourself for the most serious countries. Like for example, in the UK, people don't tend to sue as much as in the US. But if you're in the UK and you're doing a retreat and people are coming from all over and you have Americans, there are the worst sue happy people. So, I mean, I hate to say that because I'm from the US, but I'm just telling it like I see it. And so you want to protect for the most serious situation. So anyway, that is one really great thing about both courses, whichever one you sign up for. But as I said, Retreats Made Easy, local form, Retreat Blueprint has the international form. So that's a difference right there. The reason too, like there's a difference in the 2 programs and how long the program goes for. So Retreat Blueprint, because it's very complex, it's also made for travel agents, travel professionals, meeting planners, that's Retreat Blueprint. The course includes a year of the Facebook group and a year of classes. In Retreat Blueprint, the classes are given every other week. So there's 26 of them throughout a year because there's 52 weeks in a year and one every other week. In Retreats Made Easy, it's shorter because it's a smaller program, right? So we give two whole months of online support in the private retreat group, the private Facebook group. And we have the six classes, and you have forever access to that. So you can always go back. All the replays are in there and everything. You've got everything you need. And I mean, God forbid you have a question, you can always answer it in the main group. It's not like we're disappearing from your life. We're not. The cool thing is, let's say you have really been wanting to do the blueprint, but it's a little bit over your price point. The blueprint is $19.97 and Retreats Made Easy is $9.97. So what you can do is you can start with Retreats Made Easy and we will allow you to upgrade to the blueprint, which is really great. So instead of having to buy Retreats Made Easy and buy the retreat blueprint, you can get Retreats Made Easy, and then you can pay the difference between the two when you're ready. You should send us an email, say, Sherry, Megan, can I upgrade? And we will switch you from one program to the other. You won't have access to the first program. We will move you to the second program. And that's how that works. So that should work out really great for everybody and make it easy for people to at least get started in learning how to put together a really great retreat. And as you guys know from listening to the webinar, one of the things that's really important to Megan and I is that you formulate your retreat in a way that makes it stand out from being a workshop, because it's really important when you think about the promise that you're making to people, that you fulfill that promise. If you're doing a workshop, it's a workshop. If you're doing a retreat, let it be a retreat. A retreat is not a day event, really. You know, the meaning of a retreat is to go within, if you look it up. And if there's no time to go within, then to me, that isn't really a retreat. So I'd like everybody to consider that in how you formulate what you're doing and to make sure you formulate it correctly. That's what we really get excited about teaching our students, and how to add really amazing experiential activities to that retreat so that it becomes a retreat. And that helps make it stand out, because you guys know how many retreats are going on out there right now. And believe me, they're going to be more, because the truth of the matter is experiential and transformational travel is the number one sector of the travel industry that's growing right now. And so you're on the wave of that. All of you are. That's what people want. They don't want to look at stuff anymore, like from a tour bus. They want to experience something deep inside that's going to blow them away, turn their head around, change their life, like blow their worlds apart. That's what they want and need. You need to get out of the digital thing and in here where it counts, right? You all know that. I mean, we have a heart-based community here of people who are healers and, you know, heart-based business coaches and all of that. You guys know what I'm saying. So the formulation, like learning that formulation and really understanding it and then being able to, if you don't, they're not going to want to pay for your retreat. And if you look at a lot of retreats out there, one of the reasons they don't sell is because the retreat leader hasn't built value on the page. Right? They don't know how to make a good sales page. And a retreat trip page is a sales page, without a doubt. You have to know how to do this correctly. And we have a great formula for doing that. So anyways, Jen is saying, would you have to do the switch within the year, or can someone go through the easy version and then get a discounted full version afterwards? Yes, Jen. Absolutely, honey. There's no time frame for the upgrade. So if you want to wait a year and you work through the course, like the course lasts those 2 months, right? And then you are still going to be going back to those videos. Believe me, know you will be going back to them and you will continue to implement the work you learn in that period of time. When you are ready to upgrade, you just send us an email. There's no time limit, honey, on that at all. You know yourself and you know when the right time to do that is. So for example, if you're starting with something local this year, great. If you want to upgrade next year, just tell us. It's fine. We're happy to do that and help you with that next level of getting that done. So those are some good questions right there. Let me see this. We had a whole bunch of really great questions. Oh, here's another one that a lot of people ask. What if I'm not sure how to formulate my retreat? Like what I should teach on my retreat? Okay. So we will help you get straight on that. The one thing, like we said on the webinar, you don't want to teach everything you know, because then it's no longer a retreat because you're stressing people out with too much information. The best way really to construct anything that you do, whether it's a course, whether it's a retreat, a live event, a workshop, is you always want to address the problem somebody is having. And people can have multiple problems. Like even in retreats, one of your problems may be you don't know what to teach on the retreat, or you may not know how to structure a retreat, or you may not know how to do book international travel, whatever it is. It's always best to have a problem and create a solution. And usually that solution inherent to it has a new problem, because everything goes from one thing to another. So for example, I could teach how to create a great retreat, and then you know that, but then you need to put it on a sales page and you may not know how to do a good sales page. So then the next thing I might teach is how to create a great sales page. And in that solution comes a new problem, right? Because once you know how to do a good sales page, now you have to know how to market that sales page, right? So there's a natural progression when we teach, when all of us teach. It doesn't matter who you are or what you teach. There's a natural progression of things. And the one thing we love to help you with when constructing your retreat and what to teach is to like think about that carefully. You know, how does your retreat lead to the next thing, and how can you construct it in that way it doesn't overwhelm people? So we love to share that information. You're going to learn a lot about that. It's going to help you not only with your retreats, but everything else you do too, because a retreat is just one formulation of an event. You can take the information you learn about formulating retreats and formulating a good sales page and marketing to anything you do. I mean, it's slightly different promoting, let's say, a live event than a retreat, but it's the same problems, solutions, sales page, everything. So in essence, in either of the programs, you're going to get a lot of business coaching in that sense, because whatever we teach you, you can translate laterally into other situations that you are marketing. So Jen was asking, did you say we only have access for 1 year? Both programs, Jen, the online part is forever. Like, you never lose access to replays of the classes and the teachings and the modules. We have forever access on both. So that doesn't change. Okay. As far as the Facebook group that's private, where we answer, we look at your homework in the main program, the Retreat Blueprint, that's a year. In Retreats Made Easy, it is a 2-month period of time. Now, in the Retreat Blueprint program, we have a lot of people that love our live classes that we give every other week so much, they want to stay longer than the year. And if you want to do that and you have that program, it then becomes a membership program. So you can join us for, let's say, 6 months or 12 months. And that's $47 a month. So you can stay even longer if you want for that program. So there are ways of staying longer. Like if you feel like you need more time to implement for whatever reason, or you've got something going on, or you did one retreat, but now you're doing something like a really out of the box and you're like, oh my God, I need some extra support. That's fine. You can get extra support. We're here for you. There's always a way to do that. So I hope that answered your question, Jen. Okay. So let me, see if I can think of some of the other questions, because we got so many emails with different questions. And please, if you have a question, you guys that are listening live right now, if you have a question, ask. I'm here to answer anything. So just put it in the chat box and I'm happy to answer whatever it is that you need. So one of the other questions people ask is, when they're first starting out, especially, is who do I work with? You know, so many of you are multi-talented. This is another thing that comes up. So maybe I should back up a little. You know, all of us have been living life for a while, and you cannot go through life without acquiring a lot of skills. And sometimes you don't even realize how skilled you are, because so many of the skills we have can carry laterally in many different directions. So when you are one of those creative people that can teach like a whole bunch of things, it helps to step back a little and evaluate yourself in a little bit different way. Like, how can you take all that you are and put it into all that you do? That's one of my favorite little personal mantras. And I'll give you an example of that. So for example, if we look at me, I'm a physician. So you might say, well, you know, what could I do with that? You know, like, if I'm not practicing, what would I do with that? Well, it's not just that that I learned over the years. And it's amazing how one thing leads to another and another. So when I was in practice, I was also head of our local medical association. I started out as treasurer, then secretary, then president, was the first woman president in my county. And I learned how to create meetings. So I got all of the hundreds of other doctors in the area. I plan monthly meetings and have a speaker and a sponsor, and that would pay for dinner and the whole works. I never really thought about that skill. However, that was the beginning of my learning about creating live events, right? And then when I sold my practice and I started working with Don Miguel Ruiz, and he needed a business manager that was planning his events and workshops. And I never really thought that I had already gathered that skill in a slightly different way. So you are always bringing those skills forward, refining them, and then using them for something else. So it's really important not to just look at the obvious, because if I just look at the obvious, then I would have to say to myself, well, you're only a doctor and that's all you can do. And that's the end, which is actually when I left medicine, how my parents looked at that. My mother actually told me she thought I would become a bad person because I have no other skills other than being a physician. Can you believe that? Crazy. It just, thank God I had more faith in myself than she did, because otherwise, I don't know, maybe I would be a bad person right now. All kidding aside, I'm sure so many of you have stories like that, but it's really getting the faith in yourself to step back and go, wow, I can take all of these different skills and combine them up. Like maybe I'm a Reiki teacher, and maybe I know meditation, and maybe I'm really good with essential oils, or I'm just using this as an example. Maybe I know how to do hoops, but combining everything into your own proprietary system, so to speak, is what makes you unique and really fun. And we all have a set of skills that we can combine together into something that we can Monetize Desiree saying mothers. I know. I mean, don't get me wrong. My mom loves me, but sometimes she says it's some crazy stuff. Anyway, so when you step back from a marketing perspective and you look at all those items that you're really good at and you pull them together in a way that's unique, because there's no one like you. People often say, gosh, I don't know why anybody would pay for what I do. But people will pay. You have unique skills. You've gone through challenges that are unique to you, yet other people have similar things. So if you've had stressful things or challenging things or huge changes in your life, those are things that people need help getting through. I firmly believe that we are here on earth to support each other, to uplift each other in some way, to make life easier for each other. So if I have a skill that I've learned and I can take my skill and use it to make something better for someone else, it's my responsibility to do that. Henceforth, the whole thing with the retreats, because I've been doing that since 2000 with Don Miguel Ruiz and 2003 in my own travel agency. And so, I don't know, we've planned hundreds and hundreds of retreats over the years, and we know what works and what doesn't work. And we so are so excited to be able to share that with you. And the same with you. You guys have those kinds of skills too. It's bringing them forth in a way that you're packaging yourself like a brand that, you know, people can wrap their hands around your mission and you and everything that you do. So you don't have to have all the answers. Let me just say that too. To get started, you don't need to have all the answers. Like when I started this business, I actually did not choose the name of my company for 2 years. And I don't think you guys were really aware of that. So when I first started in Wanderlust Entrepreneur, because I had been teaching the Four Agreements before that, in 2014, when I started this company, Wanderlust Entrepreneur had no name. I just started out teaching about retreats. I wasn't sure yet where I was going with all of it. I knew I wanted to teach about retreats, but I didn't have a name. So I just used my name, Sherry Rosenthal. It's okay. You know, everything unfolds. Some of us get so stuck in creating our businesses and putting ourselves out there because they're like, oh, I don't know what the name of my business is, and I don't know exactly what I'm going to do, and I don't know this, and I don't know that. Well, I didn't know either. So, you know, just do, you know, clarity comes from engagement. So you need to take action to get clarity. If you don't take any action, like a lot of people go, oh, I haven't figured it out. You're never going to figure it out. Those things don't come from the ego mind. They come from your soul expressing itself. And that happens through action. And that's something I had to learn because, as you probably guessed, I'm like a very logical and linear person. And so if something's not logical, my mind will want to stop me from doing something because I don't have the answers. And I've learned to move past that, to just take inspired action. So I knew I wanted to teach retreats, and I did a bunch of webinars to test the concept, and I got really good engagement. And that's when I created the course around retreats. And then after teaching for 2 years, I realized my higher mission around the retreats was really Wanderlust Entrepreneurs, because the bigger idea there is to be able to travel the world and touch lives. And my personal thing is, personally, I think travel blows people away. I think it's life-changing. I think when you meet people of different cultures, different religions, different ways of life, it makes us more tolerant. I think if everyone traveled the world and didn't hide in their little holes, I think they would not be war. because we would fall in love with each other as we would understand each other more. But that said, that's where the Wanderlust Entrepreneur came. And one of the things Wanderlust Entrepreneur does is it teaches about retreats. Another thing it does is it teaches heart-based entrepreneurs who want to create retreats, how to create retreat-ready businesses. And there's more things that Wanderlust Entrepreneur will be doing as it comes to us. So that's sort of a roof for the many things that will live underneath that roof. But it's okay. I didn't know any more than the retreats when I first started. And like I said, I didn't even have a name. So I just used mine. Mag says, I'm looking forward to learning and working with you, Sherry. Oh, thank you, Mag. So am I. I'm really excited. I'm excited you're going to be joining us. And yes, Petya, clarity comes from engagement. That is a really is something I say all of the time, and it has been truth, at least in my life. So those things are all really important things, and I would not allow them to stop you from moving forward. And you'll see in everything you have to test, like it's never good to just do something without testing it first. You want to test your concept. So when you create your retreats, you could even do an online webinar or something covering some of those concepts and see how do people react? What do they say? What do they want? What do they need? And then all that information you can use in further expanding what you're doing. So we will be teaching about that in the course. And you just want to move forward with your dreams. Never let your logical mind stop you from creating what you want. If that's the case, I would have stayed in medicine and I would have never left. And I'd be wanting to slit my throat right now because it's just, yeah, it's not something I ever want to do. I like working in my jammies for most of the day and, you know, having the freedom to travel where I want and run my business from wherever I want. So last year it was fun. I got to be in Morocco for 2 weeks. Then I was in the south of France in Aix-en-Provence for 5 weeks. And then I was in later in the year, I lived for a month in Italy. I was in Milan for 3 weeks and I was in Lake Como for 1 week. So as long as I have a computer, I can work from wherever. And it's great. I could never do that in medicine. You know, I'm stuck in the office and stuck covering patients on weekends. And this is a heart passion for me. And of course, I love working with patients. I still run into them when I go back to St. Pete and visit my parents. But it's great to do what I'm doing now. I touch so many more lives. It's amazing to me, even though I had a big practice, our email list in this business right now is almost 75,000 people. I like never in my life could even conceptualize touching 75,000 people. It's like, I don't know. It's hard to explain. It's like magic or a dream come true or something. I don't know. I wish that for everybody because you can help so many people and you can inspire so many people and change lives. And you watch, like one of my favorite things in our course Facebook group is when someone actually fills a retreat and they post and it's their first or second, or who cares? It could even be their 10th retreat. Just filling that retreat makes you feel so good. And they post about it and they put up pictures from the retreat and share their perspectives and things that they learned, like what they did wrong and what they did right and what they're going to do next time. But it makes me feel so good because I feel like, wow, you know, I changed their life. That one retreat leader's life. And that one retreat leader is now running retreats that are changing all those other lives. And though those people, when their lives are changed and they're happier, are going to change other people's lives. And like in my mind, I picture this huge, like, spidering thing of outreach where people's lives are improving for the better in some way, whatever it is. So some may be going on health retreats, and some may be going on business retreats, and some may be going on spiritual retreats, and other people are going on knitting retreats, and they're expanding their creativity in ways they never thought they would. Exactly, the domino effect, Petya says. Absolutely. So I want that for everybody. I want everyone to be able to expand their reach and not be afraid to do online marketing. I feel like, you know, one thing I see often in the spiritual realm is a lot of people don't like learning the technology. And I feel very strongly about this, that that's so selfish in so many ways, because you're keeping yourself small. And the technology, yeah, I mean, do I enjoy technology? Hell no. I find it dreadful in many ways. I'm more of a like to work with people. But learning the technology, like even learning how to do this Facebook Live, helps me reach people, which is my mission, right? So if I said to myself, I'm afraid to get on video, I don't know if I can do it, I don't know if I like it, I hate like seeing the video of myself or hearing the sounds of my nasal New York voice or whatever it is, you know, we judge ourselves harshly, then that would prevent me from reaching people. But by, for example, even doing this Facebook Live, look how many people I can reach and how many lives I can touch. And that selfishness is when we think small and our ego mind gets in the way and it says, no, I can't do this. I'm not good enough. I can't talk on video. I can't learn the technology. I can't learn how to do a WordPress website. I can't do a Facebook ad. I can't write a blog. I mean, oh my God, yes, you can. If I can, I'm a physician. What the hell do I know about any of this? I learned. I mean, I figure if I can learn how to do surgery, I ran a surgical residency program. If I can learn how to cut people and not kill them, I think I can learn how to use Facebook Live, right? I mean, really, the same for all of us. It's just stuff. You just have to get over yourself and know that you are smart enough to learn anything. Seriously, we all are. We're all capable. You know, I'm not the most brilliant person in the world. Like, I'm not a Mensa genius. Have an average normal IQ, and I'm just like you guys. So if I can create a business and from 2014 that goes from zero to 70,000 people, you can if you want to. You don't have to. I mean, everyone can create the kind of business they want, but I just want to let you know that you can do anything you want, whatever it is. And don't be selfish and say, I can't learn this or I can't do this. Because when you do that and you don't put yourself out there, the things that you're meant to teach, the people can't find you. And if they can't find you, then they're going to suffer. They continue to suffer without your help. So you want to get out there and you want to educate yourself and learn marketing and learn how to do a good retreat sales page and learn how to formulate your retreat so that people can find it and get excited about it and not have a ugly boiled chicken retreat page that no one's going to sign up for. That's just, yeah, that's being selfish, seriously. So hopefully some of the things I'm talking about right now are helpful. Let me know if they are. Just give me a yay or a nay in the chat box if you're finding any of this helpful or if I'm just talking to myself. Maybe I am. I don't know. I could be. I've done that before. So anyway. I really enjoy hanging out with you folks. And let me know if you have any questions. Please ask. I'm here for you. If you have a question, and even if you're not watching this live, if you post a question, either me or my team will answer your question. So don't be afraid. Greta says, helpful. Thank you. Great, Greta. I appreciate it. Thank you for posting something. It's nice to know someone's actually listening and I'm not talking to myself. That's always the thing you're concerned about when you're talking live. Like, is anyone actually listening? Does anyone care? Maybe they do. Anyway, it's so interesting, the whole thing about retreats and transformational travel. I am really excited that it's become such a popular sector right now, because it's something the world needs. Don't you guys think so? I mean, with all of the political stuff going on, not just in the U.S., it's going on all over the world. I mean, sometimes when you live in the U.S., you're kind of surrounded with your news, but I love listening to the BBC news and kind of getting more of a worldwide idea of what's happening in the world. And this, it's all over, is so stressful. And I think that's why the experiential and the transformational market is booming so much. And like with everything in business, you don't want to be like a late adapter. I don't know if you guys know what that means, but you know, early adapters are the people who latch on to an idea early. So for example, when the iPhone first came out, the early adapters are the people that got rid of their little flip phones and moved to an iPhone. And the late adapters are the ones that waited until they were already like five versions of the iPhone before they bought one. So same thing here with the retreats. You want to be an early adapter. You want to be on the head of the wave, not the tail end of the wave, because that's going to give you a chance to really stand out and be leading in the industry. And you see that in any business. And I'll give you an example. I need a sip of water. Hang on. So an example of that would be, when I moved, for example, to Florida from New York, I had been practicing up in the New York area, and I moved to Florida, and there were a lot of people practicing there. And the people who had the most successful practices were the guys who started years ago, and they've been around forever, right? So they're on the front end of the curve, and everyone else who's coming in later are the end of the curve. And it's more challenging for those people to make their mark. They have to work harder. Like if you're the first one in your niche, you're going to dominate the niche, right? So that is something that I'm sure makes sense when you think about it in that way. But now that wave is really rising. So you want to be in the front of that in your niche. Like, yes, there's a ton of yoga retreats, but you know, to be honest with you, when I look at most yoga retreats, I'm sorry to say this, I'm just being honest, I think most of them suck. They're just retreat, they're like yoga classes in a pretty location. Like really, you can't do anything better than that? So you're doing your yoga retreat in Ibiza, or you're doing it in Greece. Okay, like, but what else is going on? How are you bringing you to the table? That's what we like to talk about in our course. That's what I mean by taking all that you are and bringing it to all that you do. I have never seen a yoga teacher only knowing yoga. Have you? I haven't. That would be like such a one-dimensional human. Like they don't know something about spirituality or oils or a special kind of meditation or something else that interests them that they're passionate about in their in life that they can't bring to the table, right? I mean, seriously, that's not possible. So the more that you bring everything to the table and you stand out and you think about, well, how can I take, you know, all those aspects of who I am and create an amazing event around that? That's the creative process of doing retreats that I find so exciting, that we love teaching about. I think that's really important. And people are getting savvy. It's like you go to your yoga classes, let's say you're into yoga, and then you want to go on a yoga retreat, but do you just want to do the same thing you do in class when you go away? To me, that's the kind of like that workshop in a pretty place thing. You're doing the same thing you're doing in the yoga class, but you're away somewhere. Like, what is the benefit? What's the takeaway? What is the incentive for me to do that? Because I could go to Ibiza on my own and spend less money. Do you know what I mean? And I can just go to my yoga classes. Like, what's the draw? You have to think about that. Are you going to have special people come in and give classes on organic cooking? Or are you going to do your, if you like oils, are you going to do your yoga retreat in the south of France when they're harvesting lavender and take your people to one of the distilleries and learn how to make the lavender oil? Like, what are you doing? You know, how are you adding your creativity to the mix? And that is what's going to make you on the leading edge of the crest, as Greta was asking, is the wave still rising? Yes, honey, the wave is still rising. It's amazing what's going on right now in the travel business. And I get all the travel magazines because my travel company, Journeys of the Spirit, is a full service travel agency. And we've been doing travel worldwide and managing and planning retreats around the world since then. So I've seen the change in the industry, in the whole industry. And it's great. Like, even in regular travel, it used to be, you know, remember when you would think of a trip, you'd think of a tour bus with a bunch of like annoying people on a tour bus and you'd go see this, that, the other thing. That is so dying, that model right now. More what people want is, if they're going to Italy, they want to stay at somebody's house or have dinner with a real person and experience a homemade meal or learn from how to make raviolis from a grandma, you know, or something real. They don't want to look. We do a lot of looking. We look on our phones. We look on the computer screen. We look, look, look. And, you know, every human has those three aspects about them: auditory, visual, and kinesthetic. When you just focus on the auditory and the visual, and you don't focus on the kinesthetic, that's leaving out a huge way that we learn and process as human beings. And I think that travel experiences that are only visual and auditory are missing that. We need the kinesthetic aspect. That, to me, is one of the best reasons for doing a retreat. It's that kinesthetic thing, that you have that balls to bones experience with something. That's what makes it unforgettable. And when you have that experience, you remember, like, some of the most intense things that happened to me on retreats, all I have to do is close my eyes and I can actually feel still those things happening to me like they happened yesterday, right? And I'm sure you all have had experiences like that. They touch you and they stay with you forever. And if we as retreat leaders can learn how to create that for others, I think that is extremely powerful. What a gift that is. And we can all do that. We're all capable of that creativity based on the things that we really enjoy, that we want to share with others. That's the magic formula, right? It's learning how to put that together and bring it forth. So you have those two components. It's the creativity part, and then there's the raw marketing of it all. It's the growing your list and knowing how to communicate with people and putting it out there. And it's, you know, as I was talking earlier about those lateral moves in life, you know, even though I didn't know diddly squat about online marketing, I did know marketing from being in practice. And my ex-husband and I used to own a Gold's Gym. So it was brick and mortar business. And I have to say, as much as the way we market has changed, marketing has not changed. The way that you share with others has not changed. In one of the biggest issues that our heartfelt entrepreneurs have is that marketing issue, because they look at that and they think to themselves, well, I don't like sales. And of course, yes, there's a technique in sales in general. However, I look at it a little bit differently. I look at it as, I don't really want to sell per se. Yes, you know, if you don't make sales, you don't have a business. Let's just be straight up about it. But the best way to share with somebody is to clarify their need so they understand how that need could be solved. Okay? If you try to sell something to somebody, it's going to feel salesy. And for sure, our heart-based entrepreneurs hate that. That's like one of the biggest complaints we always hear. And so they might even create a great retreat, but they don't market it, and so it doesn't fill because they're thinking they have to make sales. But the thing is, if you educate people, and this is something I took from being in medicine for 18 years. So listen carefully to what I have to say here. When I was a physician, the one thing I realized is physician means teacher. You're actually educating people on their problem so that they can make an educated decision on how to solve that problem. In the education process, they understand that you're an expert and that you can help them. So then once you have educated them on their problem and they understand it, then when you give the solution, they're going to make that choice to say yes most of the time. And sometimes they want a second opinion, and that's cool. There's nothing wrong with that, but you've educated, and it's what I like to call teaching to sell, right? Nothing has changed since I was a physician and I started practicing in 1983. Oh my God, that's so long ago. Makes me feel really old. But that method of educating someone on their problem so they can make a good decision on the solution is the best way to sell anything. And that is something we teach in both of our courses, teaching to sell. If you do that, you will not feel salesy. I know I'm educating you all. And if you hear what I'm saying and you understand it, in all likelihood, you will make a choice to join us. I mean, if you want to do retreats the right way, you'll understand it's a good choice. I don't have to sell you, and I don't want to sell you anything, really. That feeling is yucky. And I didn't do it when I was in practice, and I don't like doing it now. So my whole thing is educating people. If you educate people in understanding what their problem is, and if you look even at our webinar, we talked about all the issues that people have doing the retreats and why they don't work. So when you start understanding that, then you understand that educating yourself afterwards, like having a good course that's going to teach you those things and give you the worksheets and legal forms and all of that that you need, is a smart decision. And that is how you all need to promote yourselves, because teaching is natural. We're all teachers. Like, for example, if you're hanging out with a girlfriend and she has a problem and you have a cup of coffee together in the coffee shop, aren't you helping that person with their problem? You're in a way teaching to sell a solution to their problem. Even though there's nothing physically you're selling, it's still the same thing. So we're always marketing in a sense. It's our nature. So when you do it that way, when you think of doing it that way, teaching, then that natural aspect of ourselves that we have, that we want to share something. If you know something, don't you want to share it? If what you know can solve my problem, don't you want to tell me? I hope you do. I don't want to keep suffering. If you've got a solution to my problem, please tell me. And I will buy it or listen to it or whatever it is. You don't need to sell me. You just need to help me. So when you think of it that way, it makes marketing so much more fun. Now, to me, marketing is not a horrible thing. At one point in time in my life, I thought, oh my God, to build my practice, I have to sell and I have to be salesy and like be one of those weird doctors in a white coat that are trying to sell you the practice. And no, you do not have to do that. You just have to be yourself. You're gorgeous, amazing, helpful, juicy, fabulous, helpful self. And if you do that, you will have a great business. It's got to happen. If you share and you're not selfish, you will always do well. I found it worked in my practice and it's worked in every business that I've had, truly. You know, when I moved to Florida, as I said, there were all these big practices already in the area, right? And a friend of mine, I had just gone through a divorce, and a friend of mine said, oh my God, Sherry, you should open up here in Florida, open up in the back of my office. He was a chiropractor and he had two rooms that just had kind of junk in them in the back of the office. He goes, I'll give you those two rooms rent free for 6 months, open a practice. But right next door to him, an office had just gone bankrupt. A guy had tried to start a practice there and couldn't make it. And he said that the big practice around the corner that had been there for like umpteen years, he couldn't compete with that. And I thought about that and I was like, I'm not competing with anybody because no one else is me. Obviously, that guy was trying to compete and there's no one out there to compete with because there's only one you. So I went into that practice with that idea. There's only one me. And I looked at what all of the people were doing and what they weren't doing. And I decided to run my practice differently than I had it run it in New York and differently from the way everyone else was running it in St. Pete. And so some of the things, just simple things I did is I decided I wasn't going to wear a white coat. And I decided I would not have my patients calling me Dr. Rosenthal, unless they wanted to, and to call me Dr. Sherry or just Sherry. And I wore as my uniform, like a polo shirt, khaki pants, and sneakers. And that is how I grew that practice. And in 7 years, I was able to sell it and go into studying with Don Miguel Ruiz and live my dream. So that practice really funded that transition. And it was just from having faith in myself that I could be, you know, even though I was coming at the end of the tail end, that I was going to bring something new and fresh to the industry because I was bringing myself. And I am fresh, just like you guys are. You're all fresh and tasty. So you can do this. And I just don't want anyone to feel like, you know, they're coming to anything late into the table because no one has seen anything like you before. And you should know that. That's really important. And not just know it, but believe it from your heart, from balls to bones, and all that good stuff. So are you guys feeling me? Am I making sense at all? Or let me know. Give me a yay or a nay. Mag says yum. Thank you, Mag. Let me know if you're feeling me and if you understand what I'm trying to say in this conversation. Just let me know below. So any questions that you folks may have about the program, about anything I've said, any of the details. One thing that a lot of folks are saying is, Sherry, you know, the class is at 3 p.m. New York time, and that doesn't work for me. And I get it. You know, we know we have a worldwide audience, and that's such a blessing, and we so appreciate it. But we know no matter what time we pick, it's going to stink for some people. So that's why all the classes are recorded. It is not necessary to be on them live. Obviously, it's fun to be on them live, but if you can't, they're recorded. And the action happens in the Facebook group. It's the same thing in both of our courses. People have lives. There's no way that everyone shows up for every class. I don't. I own probably, like, I hate to say this, like 25 programs, because I love, I like learning. I'm a bit of a learning junkie, and I like to also see what other people are doing so I can keep it on top of my wave. But I never go to those live classes. I always listen to the replays, because first of all, I'm busy. I don't have time to be on all of those classes. And what I like to do is I like to use Enounce, or now Chrome has an extension that you could use to make videos play faster. You all familiar with that? So I'll watch the replays, which you cannot do with a class, right? With a class, it just takes that amount of time. On the replay, you can turn up the speed to make it be like double time, which is great for me, because, you know, and then if something's confusing to me, I slow it down and I replay that section and listen again. But otherwise, I go fast. You know, I'm a pretty fast learner. So it's almost, for me, better to listen to the replay than to listen to the live class. So I just don't want anyone to feel bad when you join a class and you can't make the live classes. It's really not that big of a deal. The big deal is to follow through and do the course and implement. That's the big deal. Okay, so a few people have posted some stuff here. Petya says, love. Max says, I'm feeling you. Cynthia says, yay, Sherry, you're amazing. Thanks so much for your support. Thank you, Cynthia. I appreciate that. Pat is saying, I'm listening here with my newborn, and I feel it's exactly what I needed to hear. Oh, you got a little munchkin with you. I love it. Cindy is saying, I feel you. Hi, Susan. She's saying, thank you. Inspirational and heartfelt as always. Sending you love, and I'm loving your hair. Yeah, I know. I totally bleached out my hair. So it's a little shocking for me to look at myself. So, and it's been a process. I really want it to be totally white, and they haven't gotten it white yet, because my hair is really dark brown plus some gray, which is dark. So, you know, bleaching it all out is kind of tough. Petya saying, baby girl is enjoying you too. Excellent. Marie is saying, any advice about making the shift from knowing to truly believing? Oh, wow, Marie, that's a crazy awesome question. I actually do have an answer for that. So this is what I do, Marie, because like all of us, you know, we all have the words of doubt in our head, right? You know, our heart wants us to do something and our head is slamming us down saying, you can't do that. It's too much. It's blah, 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 whatever it's saying. My way of solving the problem is to keep taking action in the face of adversity. And that works for me. So the key is to take action that's going to get you the reaction you want. And that reaction is going to squish that nasty thought form. So, for example, if my mind is saying, Sherry, you cannot master video. You know, you sound terrible. You look terrible. You don't know what you're doing, blah, blah, blah. Well, the thing to change that is to keep doing video. And to be honest, yeah, probably the first ones I did sucked. They were bad. But it's okay. It doesn't matter, you know. But you keep doing it, right? And then you get better and better and better and better. That's natural. So you really want to do that. And as you do that, then those voices get less. Like, I don't hear that anymore in my head about video. I'm okay now. Am I perfect? Like, am I Oprah on video? No. Will I ever be like her? Maybe not. Who cares? I'm like me and it's fine. And that's all that matters. So again, action, and it has to be strategic action, because what happens is the ego mind likes us to take action that proves that negative belief to be truth. So I'll give you an example of this. I always believed I couldn't write. I mean, to the point where I wouldn't write a letter without my parents actually checking it for me. Like, I'd have my stepfather check everything I wrote, term papers, anything. In practice, even a letter I would have to write, I'd write it and he would look over it. I just felt, I was always told in school I couldn't write. I was a terrible writer. So when I started studying for Don Miguel Ruiz, he said to me, Sherry, the best way to get over your fear of writing, he goes, you can write. I don't believe anything you tell me. So you can write. You just believe you can't write. And so every time you write something, it sucks, and you prove to yourself that you can't write. He says, you've got to take action that's going to change that. So he says, I want you to write a book. So I'm like, I can't even write a letter and you want me to write a book. He goes, you're paying me for my advice, write a book. I'm like, okay, I'm not going to argue. I'm not going to be not coachable, right? So I write a book. I try to get it published, my first book. No one wants to publish it. I'm like, see, I suck. He goes, you don't suck. Keep going. Then out of nowhere, you know, my intent is really strong. I want to get over this. And I keep putting that out to the universe. And then I get a letter from Alpha Publishing asking me to write The Idiot's Guide to Toltec Wisdom. So I'm one of three people they sent the letter to, making the proposal. And they wanted the three people to do a table of contents of everything that they would include in the book and submit it. So I really sat with that. And from my heart, I wrote down all the things I'd love to learn about the Toltec path, which is what the Don Miguel Ruiz teaches. So I send in that proposal and I get accepted. So my first book never gets published, right? Now I get this, but I learn a lot in writing the book. So that prepares me for this next adventure. I start writing the book. They said, we need the first chapter by this date. I send in the first chapter and I'm not kidding you. I'm telling you absolutely the truth. I get a letter, an email back saying, this is absolutely the worst writing we have ever seen. I was like, you see, I suck. And they said, you have to take money from your advance. We want to hook you up with an editor, and she's going to take what you have written and fix it. And you have to pay for that. So I'm like, okay, great, fine. So I'm writing chapter by chapter, the whole entire book, giving it to the editor. She's making changes. And of course, she's tracking the changes in Word. And I can see everything that she asked me a question about and the suggestion she has. As I'm going chapter by chapter by chapter through the book, by the end of the book, I actually learned how to write because she taught me chapter by chapter, and the book got published. And then I had her edit my first book, which I couldn't get published, and I self-published that. So The Idiot's Guide to Toltec Wisdom was published by publisher. And the second book, well, which is the first book, really, Banish Mind Spam, I self-published that. And then I actually wrote a third book on forgiveness that I took back from the publisher. I wrote it with a friend and turned it into an online program. So you can see that if I could do that, and I absolutely believe with every cell in my body that I couldn't write, that I finally got over it. Now, oh my God, all we do, Megan and I, is write. I mean, write courses, we write blog posts, we write newsletters, we write everything ourselves. And we've gotten good at writing. And that's because I never stopped. I listened to my teacher. He said, keep doing it and you will get better. Am I Hemingway? No, I'm not Hemingway. I probably never will be. That's not my sweet spot in life. This is my sweet spot in life. I love to teach. I'm a good physician, but I'm a good enough writer that I know now how to copy. Oh, and that's another thing. First, I started to understand how to write. Then I had to learn how to copyright. Once I had an online business, I didn't know how to do that. I had to learn. So again, everything is a learning process and you can do it. You even if you don't believe it, just keep doing it and put yourself in a situation where you can succeed. So allowing the editor to edit my work and show me what I was doing wrong, chapter after chapter after chapter after chapter, you know, eventually you get the hang of it because you're making the same mistakes over and over again. So you start fixing them because you're learning. So that is really, really important. Desiree says, to anyone who is considering the course, I'm a repeat student. I got sidetracked, but now getting back on track. Sherry, Megan, and team are awesome and accessible. The full course I took is full of great info and guidance. I have no regrets. Oh, Desiree, that's like a warm, fuzzy hug. Thank you, love. And I'm glad you're getting back on track. Because that is important. It doesn't matter so much that you fell off the wagon. What matters is you're getting back on the wagon and you are going to do it. So thank you for sharing that. I love that. Marie says, thank you for your response. It's very helpful. Thanks for sharing your own experience. So hard to believe that you ever had trouble writing. Girlfriend, oh my God. If you, oh my God. I just wish I had some of my old writing. So you can actually look at how bad it was. It was bad. It was bad. I'm not saying that to be judgy. I'm saying that because that's the what is. And I do my best to tell it like it is. And right now, I feel like I'm a good writer. Megan and I just got a book contract. Don't know if you guys know that. And so the book will probably come out in March of next year. And the whole book is written out. Megan did a good portion of the writing. And is it perfect? Hell no. But we're going to have an editor go through it and fix it all up. So that's all that matters. You know, there's always a way to get this out there. And I never thought I'd ever publish books. I'm sure Megan didn't either. You know, writing was not her strongest skill either. And she's really learned to be a good copywriter. I think she's got me beat out in the copywriting department. She's really good. Nellie says, hey there, very excited. Has just joined the program. Just wondering what happens after the 6 weeks. Is there support on questions or requests afterwards? That's a great question, Nellie. The support is for 2 months in the Facebook group together. You're going to have forever access to the online program. So you'll always be able to go in there and all the information is going to be there. You know, if you have a question, it's beyond the 2 months. You can always ask a question in the main group and we can answer it there. Also, if you like with time, you can upgrade to the Retreat Blueprint, which has a longer support time with it. you can do that. So we're not going anywhere, Nelly, and we don't plan on abandoning anyone. That's just not our thing. So I think you're going to be fine, honey. We take good care of you. Okay, let's see if there's some other questions. I feel like I've been talking a long time. I think I have. It's already 1 p.m. Any questions that I can answer for anybody? Do share. Put it in the chat box and let me know. I can see it. By the way, I'm doing this Facebook Live using a technology called BeLive TV. And it's really great because when you do Facebook Lives on your phone, it's so little and I can't see anything anymore. On my phone, it's so small. So now it's great because I can do a Facebook Live on my computer and everything that you write is really big and I can actually see your comments, which is fabulous. I really appreciate. So feel free to write a message because I can actually see it, which is great. So anyway, just for those of you, if you're not sure, the registration is going to close on Tuesday night at midnight because we need to get everything processed if we can. If you're planning to join us late, please send us a note and let us know you want to join, but you're going to join late. That way we can work that out. So registration is going to close on Tuesday night at midnight, California time. And then the first class is going to start on Thursday. Again, the class is going to be given at 3 p.m. New York time. When it's done, we're going to take that and put it right on the website for you. So you'll have that right away. Susan's asking, didn't get to call at the beginning. What exactly is this program? Susan, Megan and I created a brand new program for newbies, first-time retreat leaders. It's more of a basic program than the blueprint is. You're in the blueprint. So this would not be something that you would want to join because you already have the blueprint. So you have everything that you need in that course. But what we did is we really simplified things down for people because people wanted something that was a little easier to do and at a much lower price point. So that's why we did that. So you're cool, Susan. You've got everything you need in the blueprint. Okay. So anyways, as I was saying, registration closes Tuesday night. We start with the first class on Thursday. As soon as the class is done and I can grab that video, I'm going to put it in the course website and you'll have it like by the end of the day. So even if you couldn't join at 3, you know, like by 6 o'clock, I should be able to have that on the website. New York time for everybody. So you'll be able to get started right away on Thursday, whether you can join the live class or not, doesn't matter. Okay. Let's see if there's any other questions. I think everybody is good. I'm just looking to see if there's any other questions. Doesn't look like it. So if there's no other questions right now, I think I'm going to hop off and then I'm going to come back on later at around 4 p.m. again for people later if they have any questions. So thank you so much for hanging out with me. It was really fun and it was great to share with all of you. And again, if you're just listening afterwards and this is not live, feel free to ask anything. Just do a post and either myself or my team will answer that immediately. So sending love to all of you. Would love to see you in the Retreats Made Easy program or even the Retreat Blueprint program. If you feel that's the program for you, you can join that now too. Either one. Mag says, thank you, Sherry. Thank you, honey. Appreciate it. Really grateful for everyone that's in our community. You mean a lot to us. And the fact that we can connect with you and touch you, no matter where you are in the world, is really very special. So anyway, bye everyone.